A variable is a way for us to easily store data values or a vector or list of values or a data set or object in R, and allows us to conveniently reference that variable name, saving us from having to rewrite the data value, vector, or object used many times throughout a program. We'll cover vectors, main R objects, and reading and data sets later on in the video series, but we first need to understand how to set up a variable so that we can write these things to a variable name. When we wrote our first Hello World program, you might recall we tied our data value to a variable name called Hello period string. So let's revisit this again. We have a variable called Hello string, and we use this assignment operator to tie whatever we want to it, such as a data value of some sort. Now, our variable name should be almost self-explanatory of what our variable is storing or referring to. So I wouldn't call a variable, say cat, and give it the value dog, for example. It's best just to give it a name that kind of makes sense. Now, you might be wondering if there are naming or style conventions for variables in R. So in R, we usually separate our one-word descriptions in our names with a period. So for example, or this could be animals period list. We can also include numbers in our variable names. So if you have like multiple data sets, you might want to call your variable dataset 1. Or if you have multiple models, for example, you might want to call it model 1. R is case sensitive too, so if you were to capitalize model 1, it will not register as we gave our variable the name model 1 all in lowercase. You can use other naming conventions as well, so such as underscore, or you could use, say, camel case. Also, a variable can only really consist of letters, numbers, periods, underscores, and they must begin with a letter or a period followed by a letter, not a number. So, for example, you cannot have a variable called two pairs, for example. This won't work. And same goes for a period followed by a number. You can, however, have two pairs, as in the letters, two pairs. And same goes for a period. And just keep in mind, you also cannot use spaces when you're naming your variables. Lastly, you can override what a variable stores by using the same variable name, but tie it to something else. So for example, animal. Animal cat. We're going to override this now with a different animal, which is dog. So we can see animal once belonged to, you know, the value cat, but we have updated it with a new value dog using the same variable name. Just note that once you override it, you permanently changed its value. So you would either have to rewrite it to cat again or give it another variable name if you would still like to use the cat value. So now that we've set up a variable, we can easily refer to the variable name throughout our program. So we don't need to keep, you know, typing out our data values or vectors or objects. In the next video, we'll cover different operators.